binanggit siya rin sa statement niya. Sabi niya,
you're... Si Briones!
Hindi, tanungin ko muna kasi napaka-importante nito.
Hindi nga nag-practice yan eh.
Nga po.
Sabi ko sa'yo, si Briones dapat talaga umarap sa akin sa debate eh. Kasi lang, he's diverting the issue here eh. Okay. Hindi ka na makasali dito, Brad, sa usapan natin ng gulo-gulo dito, nang gugulo ka eh. Abogado ka lang eh. Gusto mo eh, pa-contempt kita, pakulong kita eh. Yung kliyente nyo, may pending pa sa akin. I'm the presiding commissioner. You call me narcissistic. Ikaw, ano ka? Do not call me narcissistic. Papayag pa ako. Sabihin mo sa ako na I am insane. Sabihin mo na I am insane.
Okay. So would you do that?
No. What do you call this? No, not a rated lawyer. Yeah, I should not be answering his remarks. He's not a rated lawyer. He's not even a judge.
Okay, pero would you cite him in contempt because of this?
No, he's my broad guy. Ipapadal na lang siya ng pegop sa layo ng mga sis.
Okay. Pero ito nga, may sinabi siya na yung...
Na siya, eh. Ayaw niya na mag-debate sa akin eh.
Opo.
Pero... Kasi yung six coach eh. Sis mo ako, senior sis mo ako. I'm most senior sis in government aside from Senator Pierredano. Briones, you call me narcissistic. If I file a libel suit against you in Bacolod, maglalakad ka sa gitna ng mga tubo.
Okay.
Brad kita, kaya siguro tinatawanan lang kita kasi yung lit-lit mo eh. Hanggang tenga lang kita eh.
Okay. Kung hindi nyo pa po alam yung decision ng kasama nyong mga commissioners sa 1st Division, pero bakit ang sabi ni Briones, yung decision nyo raw, minority decision opinion?
Eh, ewan ko sa kanya. Ibig sabihin, alam niya na may nasuhulan siya. May nasuhulan ba siya? Bakit alam niya na minority yung akin? Alam niya na yung boto ng dalawa kontra? You catch the fish in the mouth. Bakit? Okay. May nasuhulan na ba kayo? May tumanggap ba ng pera?
What do you think?
Yan, tanong ko sa kanila.
Okay.
Did money change hands? How come you know that mine is a minority opinion?
Okay.
That the majority is in favor of your whatever client.
Nangyari lang iniisip na marami. Ano niya nasabi ng minority opinion?
Sabi ko separate opinion eh because I did not know their votes yet. Wala pang resolution. Wala pang punensya. How can mine be a dissenting opinion? Hindi nga nag... Briones, hindi nag-practice ng law yan eh. Matagal yan sa PhilCOA kay JPE. Sumbong kita kay JPE ha. Tawag mo ako narcissistic ha. Ikaw, okay. Napoleonic complex ka. Kaya may inferiority complex ka kasi maliit ka eh.
Okay.
At hindi ka magwapo. Ano ngayon?
Okay.
Alam mo, Mr. Misguera, I can speak English much better than you if I want and you know it. Dinatagalan ko dito kasi bastusan na to eh.
Okay.
Bastusan na to. Baka nakalimutan nyo, nag-mayor ako.
Okay.
Ng Warlord City ng Cadiz. Oh. 27 anyos lang ako. Sagutin ko yung mga tanong nyo na tama. Wala yung mga tanong nyo na narcissistic ako. Kulang nyo lang. Sabihin nyo na, baliw ako eh. Can you imagine that I can write all these things and I am mentally ill?
Okay. Let's go to the other issue that they raise against you. Yung the fact that you made your opinion public, they claim that this is ano. This is not, this should not have been done.
It is Commissioner Ferulino who may be liable under Section 3C of the Anti-Graft and Corrupt Practices Act. Why? Because she's delaying the release of a resolution to favor a litigant. That is an impeachable offense. Sinasalang niyo si Commissioner Ferulino dito nang bago-bago po siyang commissioner. Sirang-sira na yung tingin ng marami sa mata ko sa kanya. Wala na akong respeto sa kanya. Sinira niyo lahat ng mga samahan namin ni Commissioner Ferulino dahil lang sa inyo. Mga saw-saw kayo. Kaya ikaw, George Briones, magpaliwanag ka sa alumni, ha? Bakit mo ako tinawag na narcissistic, ha? Narcissist mo ako. Sige, Mr. Esguera, next question.
Okay, have you ever gotten in touch with Commissioner Ferulino after this? No. Nagkausap na ba kayo o hindi pa rin?
The last text na was 24. So I told Commissioner Casqueo, why don't you be the one to call her? You tell her if she cannot do it, she can waive it and you can take it over even if I know you're also very busy. But at least we have an assurance that it will be released before my retirement.
Okay.
But she did not reply to ano. to Commissioner Casquiel. So in executive session, I told the chair and the commissioners my problem. And so I asked the chair that he should be the one to call Commissioner Ferolino and perhaps she will answer. Yeah, instead, she issues a memorandum explaining her delay at the same time attacking me for wanting publicity. Ayun na naman may Commissioner Ferolino, sikat na ako bago ka pa dumating dyan eh. Sikat na ako bago ka pa dumating dyan, hindi ko na kailangan ng publicity. Gusto okay. ko lang, mag-retire ako with honor, integrity, and excellence.
Okay.
Hindi yung pinababoy nyo yung presiding commissioner nyo. What, you are disrespecting me? You have no respect for me as your senior commissioner and presiding commissioner.
Okay.
If I had more than 5 days to now, be in COMELEC, I'm really going to make you account for this discourtesy.
She's okay.
already...
Commissioner.
Ferolino makes it appear that she's the victim here. No,
okay.
the people are the victim here.
Okay, you made that clear, no? Pero given this...
My vote can be counted.
Okay, given this back and forth...
Too, so that my vote will be counted.
Okay. You made that clear, no? So, given this back and forth between you and Commissioner Ferolino, how do you think this could affect whatever decision would ultimately come out? Kasi baka naman magkaroon na talaga ng duda.
Whatever the outcome is. Decision will come out, will go up anyway on motion for reconsideration. And then will go up anyway to Supreme Court. I keep on telling all these Marcos loyalists, you know, it is to your benefit na. It's in everybody's benefit and interest that this case goes up to the Supreme Court as soon as possible. Why? What if Bongbong Marcos is DQ'd by the Supreme Court, you know, 1 week before elections? Who will he substitute? How will he substitute campaign? What if he is DQ'd by the Supreme Court after the elections and he has not substituted?
Okay.
He will not be able to assume office. What if he wins but he was DQ'd? He will be removed from office. That is why it is better that this case goes to the Supreme Court as soon as possible. It is in the nation's interest. Why are you okay. holding your resolution there as if that is the final?
Let's go to your basis, the arguments or the basis that you cited in your opinion to disqualify Bongbong Marcos. Sabi niyo maliwanag, it's a crime that involved moral turpitude. But others were claiming na it's very difficult to determine whether that particular crime, non-filing of ITR for 4 years, constituted a crime of involving moral turpitude. How did you arrive at that?
Let the Supreme Court decide this so that I will know if I am right or wrong. Huh? How can you be more scholarly than I am? Can you claim to be smarter than I am in the law and jurisprudence? No lawyer here, except justices of the Supreme Court, can claim that they can read the law better than me.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, by golly. Let's have a debate on national TV. Even Briones already backed out because he does not meet the height requirement.
Okay. So, how did you determine that, yung moral turpitude, when others were claiming na hindi raw siya ganun kaliwanag?
Tell me. Very simple things. Way, simple lang na tao dyan, no? Tricycle driver, tanungin mo. Yung matanda na sabi nila nagnakaw ng 10 kilong mangga, kinulong nila. Moral turpitude, pag nanakaw. Sa Australia, traffic violation, moral turpitude. They will cancel your application for citizenship. Moral turpitude. Traffic violation lang ha. Nag one-way street ka lang. Dito sa Pilipinas, ibig mo sabihin, hindi ka nag-file ng income tax return, 4 beses bilang gobernador ng Ilocos at ang presidente at diktador ay ama mo, hindi pa yon moral turpitude. Tanoy mo batang maliit na magaling ang pagpalaki ng magulang, good ba yan ako, bad? Ay bad yan, di siya nagbayad eh. Utang yan sa gobyerno eh. And
sure.
He was convicted. Convicted! Marcos
yeah.
Jr. is convicted. He's a convict. How many times do I have to say that he's a convict? He was convicted twice in the regional trial court and in the court of appeals. But he did not pay the fine. He did not even bother to pay the fine. So how am I supposed to help him, even if he's the brother of my seatmate, Aimee Marcos? How can I help him in some way when that is everything that he did is on record, admitted by his lawyers? Okay. I cannot find any legal justification for his actions. I cannot conclude but say that all of those failure to file income tax returns for 4 years and failure to fine, to pay the fine in regional trial court, were intentional. Mm. Were intentionally done with a cavalier attitude, yeah, being the son of the president who thought that he was above the law.
Okay. So you made that very clear, which reminds me, when we interviewed the attorney Briones before, he was very somehow cavalier about it as well. Ang claim niya, in the non-payment of, non-filing of ITRs for 4 years, wala rong pinagkaiba, it's as simple as jaywalking. So that was her attitude at that time, jaywalking lang daw, parang jaywalking lang daw yan.
Nagnakaw nga ang tao, 10 kilong mangga ay kinulong nila. Ito, bali, pag nanakaw din ito ng buwis sa gobyerno, 4 na taon, eh hindi nagbayad ng multa, hindi ito moral turpitude. Ay, pambihira naman. Ano bang reasonable ni standard lang po ito, attorney? Summary po si summary, summary lang ang COMELEC. Hindi po kami criminal case na beyond reasonable doubt ang standard. Substantial evidence lang po, pambira naman kayo. Kasi hindi naman kayo nagpa-practice sa COMELEC eh. Never naman kayo nag-appear dyan sa amin. Hirap naman na nagpapanggap kayong expert-expert kayo. Wala naman kayong alam sa election, no? Ah, estudyante ko kayo, ilang beses na kayo na 5 isang araw.
Okay,
and that note. Hindi natin Attorney Briones. You let okay. Attorney Rodriguez speak for his client. Saw-saw okay. Itong partido mo na hindi naman kayo kasali. Contempt na kita pag nainis ako sa'yo eh. Bukas, okay. Contempt na kita.
Okay, that note, thank you very much, Commissioner Rowena Guanzon, for joining us tonight. Good luck on your retirement on February 2.
Alam nyo, kawawa lang si George Briones eh. Sinalang nyo lang dito para may diversionary tactic eh, which is very bad ha. I can see what you are doing. Let's focus on the question of Commissioner Ferolino, when are you going to release your Ponentia resolution?
Yeah, actually, nasagot nyo na po yan. So,
release it before February 2 so that I can attach my vote and separate opinion.
Yeah.
If you do not do so, you may be liable under Section 3C of the Anti-Graft on Corruption and Corrupt Practices Act, which may be an impeachable offense.
Okay.
Thank you very much, mga okay. Kababayan.
Thank you for making that clear. Thank you for joining us tonight, Commissioner Guanzon.
Thank you very much.